Number six.
Everybody is starting to see what a terrific talent Anthony Rendon is.
I like everything about Anthony Rendon. And when he was in the batter's box, no matter if it was the World Series, the Division Series, he just sits there and he does his thing.
He might be the best right-handed hitter in the game of baseball.
It's a grand slam for Anthony Rendon!
He's not just a good hitter, he's a great hitter.
I don't think there's anyone better in the game. He just makes it look too easy.
He's a total package. I think he's a superstar.
He can do it all, Anthony Rendon.
And the entire Angels organization, it is my pleasure to welcome you today as we introduce the newest member of the Los Angeles Angels, Anthony Rendon.
Number five.
Alex Bregman is the best player right now.
At his best when it matters most.
Unreal Alex Bregman.
What a play by Bregman. How about this Bregman?
There wouldn't be any other guy in the world that I want in a pressure situation.
Grand slam! Alex Bregman!
The 2 train has left Union Station.
Alex Bregman is a bad, bad dude.
Is one of the game's best.
I feel like I'm gonna go do damage every time I step in the box.
A big shot to left field, and big shot Bregman rounds the bases.
He plays with an edge. He's awesome.
Bregman brings that swagger.
He's the best player the game has right
now. I had Rendon at 9. Where'd you guys have him?
I had him at 8.
I had him at 4.
Ooh, okay. If we're gonna project, do we think Bregman's gonna be, he's gonna have a better year than Rendon and Arenado?
Oh, wow.
With everything he's gonna deal with this year.
Mm. He's gonna have a huge year.
You think he'll have a huge year?
He'll have a huge year, yeah.
He's another guy we were talking about earlier with Arenado. He's another guy with swagger.
I think he's another guy that might take this as an impetus to chip on his shoulder.
Yeah,
I agree.
To do something crazy.
Okay, as for Arenado, new league, big contract. Rendon, yeah. Is Rendon the kind of guy that you're going to go, I hope this first year of the contract, he doesn't try to do too much?
Listen, man, I don't know. When I watch Rendon play, I don't even know if he's awake at the plate. You know what I mean? He's like so relaxed, so calm, and then, bam, electricity. You know, that's just how he does it. And you saw it in the postseason last year, man. But just go back. You know, Ronnie, when you see this guy set up and when you're facing him, man, it just seems so easy, quiet. He can look at him right here. He's just sitting in his lounge chair, and then, bam, he gets that right there against Kershaw in Game 5. What a huge homer that was in a 3-1 ball game. We know what happens after that, but you saw this too, another one, Game 5, extra innings, hits a rocket off the fence. Big hit after big hit after big hit. When you think Rendon, you just have to think about all these huge hits that he had down the stretch in the postseason. Game 6 again, man, this guy just came through big in the 9th earlier on with that home run. I mean, he did it all season long. His numbers were almost identical in the postseason. And I tell you what, they couldn't get to Greinke. One out in the 7th. You remember that. That kind of got the party started.
No doubt.
Got it to 2-1. Yeah. Greinke got out of the game. Next thing you know, the Nationals end up being world champions. But this guy, for me, he's a guy that projects well over 162 because the game's slow for him. The ball, he lets it travel. He doesn't get fooled too much. He's going to do great out there in Los Angeles because this guy is just that swing plays anywhere.
He's also coast to coast, which helps him. His power to all fields. There's only two players that I've ever said this about. One I played against, Paul Molitor, and I used the phrase slump-proof swing. And I use it when I watch Anthony Rendon. He's got a slump-proof swing.